Just got my PICC line put in.
Wasn't
painful at all. It was actually really, really good. But now I'm off to get admitted into the hospital to start the chemo for my auto stem cell transplant.
That's weird looking.
Yeah.
Like it's hiding from the sun.
It's like the chemo paparazzi. It's using its SPF.
I should know that, but let's see. Here, I'll play a song I wrote, okay?
Okay.
All right? I did write this, actually. With him in all his glory, what would you ask if you had just one question? Yeah, yeah, God is great. Yeah, yeah, God is good. Like, and would you wanna see if seeing meant that you would have to believe in things like heaven and in Jesus and the saints and all the prophets? Yeah, yeah, God is great. Yeah, yeah, God is good.
You wrote that.
I did, yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Wow.
Quite some years ago, sneaks up on you.
Did Alanis record that?
It was Joan Osborne.
Oh,
it was
it
the same
Joan?
Time as Alanis.
Oh my goodness. Oh.
Alanis actually won the Grammy that year. We should have won.
Yeah.
We got he was robbed.
That's right. Awesome.
That was you ought to know. Record of the actually song of the year was what I was up for. Yeah, that was the album. The song of the year, I was nominated for that, and Seal won that with Kiss from a Rose.
Oh, yeah. Kiss, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, the Batman theme, yeah. Awesome. Yeah. Great, thank you.
Well, my pleasure. Thanks for listening.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Bye-bye.
Have a nice evening.
You too.
Hi, everybody. Yesterday was my first day here. I got my PICC line put in. This thing. It's actually really annoying. Gets stuck on everything because it's hanging out all the time and pulling, but whatever. I have my port plugged in too that they're not working, so what's the point? But anyway, I had no trouble really with the PICC line. It didn't really hurt putting it in. The only thing you feel is the needle going in and then all the tubing. The tubing goes all the way down to my heart and I didn't feel any of that. It wasn't too bad, but now it's just kind of sore. After I got my PICC line put in, well, before then I asked for sedation. I had this nurse that was giving me a hard time with that, but I finally got my sedation and it helped a little bit calm me down, but the procedure actually wasn't that bad. But after that, the sedation, for some reason this time, gave me a horrible side effect. I think that's what it was from. I couldn't stand. I was at a food store, the pretzel store, and I was like falling on the ground because I couldn't stand up and I couldn't walk. I felt dizzy and miserable and lightheaded. And I had to steal a chair in the parking garage, a wheelchair, and this guy saw me and he wheelchaired me all the way up to my room and I just laid in bed all day, really not feeling well, so I don't know what the hell that was. Yesterday was day one of chemo. I had my first chemo drug called a BCNU, part of the BCV regimen, and that hit kind of hard. Not nausea-wise, but pain. I had a horrible, brutal headache that I couldn't see light, I couldn't see my phone, it was really painful, and really bad mouth pain, like my jaw, my teeth, my tongue, my throat, like my whole face was just hurting so bad. They gave me oxycodone, and usually I can't take narcotics, I can't tolerate it, but we had no choice because of how severe it was. But I took it, did nothing, so they gave me another, I think they gave me two, and then the headache finally went away to a dull pain, and I was able to get a couple hours of sleep. I'm on day two. I had etoposide earlier, didn't really have any side effects besides I'm starting a weird fever for some reason, but it's not too bad yet. And right now, I just got hooked up to Cytoxin, which I'm actually really worried about. We'll see how this goes. It's already miserable here. I have the same view as last time of buildings and nothing. And the only channel I watch is MTV. And they don't have it here. I even asked if I can purchase it, and they don't have it. I can't. I know some people can shake their head at that, but seriously, that's my only entertainment. I have nothing in here. I can't even look at a bird. Like, I can't. There's nothing. It's miserable when you have weeks and weeks and just, it's like a prison. There's nothing to do. And that would be my only entertainment for me. And yeah, well, so this is day two. I have 5 days of this, a day off, and then I get my transplant. So I feel okay right now, which is good. It's supposed to kick in later, but feeling pretty good right now, so it's good. So I am done with the chemo. I didn't film too much, and I probably won't film too much because
it is just so miserable and uneventful. I'm just laying in bed all the time. I haven't eaten for days. I can't even barely hold this camera up. I get my transplant tomorrow. Tomorrow morning. I'm scared, but I'm more scared of the side effects after the transplant. I'm scared of feeling even worse than I do because people said I'm going to feel worse than I already do. My counts are going to drop really low before they go up for a while, and I just want to get out of here. I really hate being away from home. I hate not being able to eat at all. I can't even drink. Well, I can drink, but I can't even eat applesauce. It's sitting up is even hard. This is the first time I'm sitting up in like days. If I already feel like this, I don't want to know what it's going to be like after a transplant. I'm so scared. I'm so scared, and I probably won't film too much because I really don't feel well. I haven't gotten sick on the chemo, thank God. I just feel like I got hit by a million trucks. I just feel so lightheaded, so weak. I can't eat because I have no appetite. I'm just so depressed. I'm glad the chemo's done. Tomorrow's transplant. It has to go downhill before it goes uphill. I'm just dreading it, but yeah. I brought stuff to do to keep myself occupied, but I can't even get up to do it. I brought magazines, I brought crafts, I brought books, but I can't even, like, sit up to do any of this. I hate this. This is horrible. I just can't wait to go home. I'm not sure how much I'll film just because of how bad I feel.